Dear all, welcome to the playlist of High Voltage Engineering. In this session, I'll be discussing the radio interference measurement from a dielectric material. So during partial discharge, bulk amount of high frequency signal that will be generating from a dielectric material. Those signals will be directly crosstalking with the communication channel. Because of that, the signal which is coming from the communication channel, that will be getting distracted. That's the main problem of radio interference. You can call it as electromagnetic interference, or short form is EMI. So how do we measure radio interference? That's a big question. So we have one meter, one facility is available, that is known as radio interference meter. With the help of radio interference meter, you can easily measure how much amount of radio frequency signal that will be generating from a dielectric material. So this is one of the examples which you can observe here. These are my references. So we can say that a high frequency signal that will be interacting with the communication circuits. Definitely the signal which is passing through the communication circuit that will be getting distracted. That is what exactly happening here. So let us study how to measure radio interference signal or radio interference with a dielectric material. So what are the facilities which are available? So we have one meter that is called radio interference meter. By using the radio interference meter, we can easily measure how much amount of radio frequency signal that is generating from a dielectric material during the discharge. So that is the main content which I would like to discuss in this session. Let us move on to the session. First and foremost thing I would like to discuss the importance of measurement of radio interference. As you know that many electrical appliances like transformers, line conductors, rotating machines produce unwanted electrical signals. So it may be in the range of radio and high frequency, definitely. So for example, television band, microwave band, etc. More than megahertz. This signal will be directly interacting with the communication channel, and the signal that will be passing through the communication channel that is getting distracted. These signals are produced due to corona discharges in air, internal or partial discharges in the insulation, sparking at commutators and brush gear in rotating machines, etc. These are the main sources of production of this kind of high frequency signal. That point you ought to note down. So it is very important to see that the noise voltage generated in the ratio and other transmission bands are limited to acceptable level. Those signals should be produced in an acceptable level. Otherwise, it will be seriously damaging to the communication or any other system. So these are the importance of measurement of radio interference signal or radio interference. Let us familiar the following circuits for the measurement of radio interference. First and foremost thing, let me go to a basic circuit for measurement of radio interference. We can familiar the following segments. The first and foremost thing, we require high voltage transformer, or you can call ST transformer. To measure the voltage, we are having a voltage measuring unit, just like a display. To control the unit, we are having a dimmer stat. Just like a dimmer stat, we are having a voltage control segment. So these are the supply system. So we have the test object. Test object in the sense dielectric test piece that is placed over there. And C1 and C2 you can observe. These are the parasitic capacitance or stray capacitance of the connecting leads. And we are having one inductor. Actually we will call the choke inductance. We are having a choke inductance over there. And similarly, we have the heart of the component that is called radio interference meter. Radio interference meter is placed over the R1 is representing the resistance of the particular meter. So this gap is giving the protection. G is representing a gap. Okay, protective gap. It ensures the protection. And S1 is actually a shorting switch. Okay. Now we can see one capacitor. This is very important to connect different stages. That is known as coupling capacitor, or you can call coupling condenser, that is placed over the. Suppose some discharge, some partial discharge is taken place in this particular dielectric material which is placed over there. Immediately, the signal that will come across the particular resistor. What you can do is, that particular signal will be transferred to the radio interference meter with the help of a coaxial cable which is placed over there. Through coaxial cable, the signal will be reached over there. So from the meter, you can able to see that the range of signal. Is it a high frequency signal or low frequency signal? So definitely if it is a high frequency signal, that will be reason for radio interference. So this is a basic setup of measuring radio interference. The heart of the component is radio interference meter, R, okay, that is placed over there. One more important information. you can able to measure the signal in the range of 150 kilohertz to 30 megahertz. This is the range of measurement. Above and below limit you cannot able to measure. Okay, so we can able to measure in this particular range. That's a peculiarity of this particular meter. So by using the setup, we can able to measure the radio interference. We can check, is it in beyond the limit or in a restricted limit? We can able to acceptable level or it is not in the accepted level. We can able to judge. Now I would like to discuss other type of circuit for the measurement of radio interference, especially power system line or power transmission line. So we have the power system conductor, PC representing a power system conductor, which is placed over there. I need to measure how much amount of high frequency signal that is generating from the power system cable. Or we can inspect that any type of high frequency signal will be generating from the power system cable. So yes or no, we can able to identify with the help of the radio interference meter. Now what you can do is you have to place the test object. This is your test object actually. PC means that itself is a test object. If you want, you can keep in vertical manner also. Vertical manner. Now we have to place the radio interference meter. That M stands for radio interference meter. R1 is representing the meter impedance. So we can see C1 and C2, that is representing stray capacitance or parasitic capacitance. That is representing the capacitance of the connecting leads. S2 is called a shorting switch. Okay, we can able to say S2, that is mainly for a shorting switch. Similarly, S1 is also belong to one of the shorting switch, which is related to this particular choke. Okay, the main purpose of this choke is to tune. So that's a peculiarity of this particular choke. And here we can see a capacitor that is mainly used for coupling different stages. That is also known as coupling capacitor or coupling condenser. And we have a resistor where the signal will be collected across this particular resistor. And we have a protective gap for ensuring the safety. Okay, it gives some certain indications. Suppose high frequency signal may be generated from the power system cable or power system conductor. Immediately you will be getting the signal across the particular resistor. That signal will be directly passed through coaxial cable to the particular meter. So we'll be getting the signal across this meter. So by analyzing the signal, we'll come to know that whether the radio interference has been occurred or not. Will the signal responsible for radio interference or crosstalking, or you can call EMI. Okay, so that's the main peculiarity. So by checking the waveforms, by checking the pattern from the meter, we'll come to know that those signal will be responsible for radio interference or not. So we can able to judge in this manner. So this is mainly used for the measurement of radio interference from a conductor of energized system. So that's a peculiarity. This is another type. One more type is available, that is based on the British standard. Let us go through how do we measure radio interference based on the British standard. So special type of circuit will be provided. As you can see, this is a special type of circuit. The supply side we can observe first. This is a high voltage transformer. You can see a high voltage transformer. And LC, there is a filter, it will act as a filter, and we are keeping a power apparatus. That means you are keeping power apparatus, especially transformer. Suppose from the transformer bushing there may be chance for production of that particular high frequency signal. That will be responsible for radio frequency. Okay, radio frequency or EMI, you can call EMI. To connect two stages, this is first stage and this will be the second stage, we are having a coupling condenser or coupling capacitor. Clear? Suppose some discharge is taken place in your apparatus, in your dielectric test piece. So that will be reflected across the inductor. Then the whole voltage has been divided by using resistive potential divider, R1 and R2. These are the two segments of the resistive potential divider. R1 is belong to low voltage arm and R2 is belong to high voltage arm. The output of the low voltage arm, that will be directly connected to measuring unit. Okay, we are having a suitable setup. So by checking the waveforms or by checking the pattern, we'll come to know that the range of or level of the frequency. Okay, that signal is producing a high frequency level or low frequency level. So based on that, we are going to predict that that will be responsible for radio interference, or you can call EMI. Will that be responsible for electromagnetic interference? We can judge based on the pattern of waveforms. Is it high frequency or low frequency also? We can able to determine. This type of setup is known as the British standard type setup for measurement of radio interference, or I have written. circuit for RIV measurement as given by the British standard. So this is a setup for measurement of radio interference voltage according to a British standard. Okay, so this is the way how to measure radio interference voltage. These are my references. Let us conclude the session. First of all, I explained the importance of radio interference measurement. So thereafter, I have explained why this test is conducting. What are the main sources of production of this kind of unwanted signal, or you can call radio frequency signal? What are the main reasons that I have explained? Afterwards, I have explained how do you measure radio interference level by using the normal circuit. You can able to measure by using the circuit, you can able to measure the frequency in the range of 150 kHz to 30 MHz. That's a peculiarity. Similarly, we can able to measure, is there any radio interference signal that will be occurring from the power system conductor? That is also possible by using the setup. However, we can say that radio interference meter is the heart of the component. So, but we have to arrange the supplementary accessories or auxiliary equipments to measure the radio interference. Directly, we cannot able to measure the radio interference. With the help of these apparatus, we can able to measure the radio interference directly. Radio interference can be called as electromagnetic interference, EMI, or you can call cross-talking. By using the British standard, you can able to measure the radio interference in this manner. That is also I have covered. Finally, thank you very much for watching this video.